Vane was spotted boarding the brig. They're hauling back their anchor as we speak.
He'll be gone within the hour. Off in search of aid, no doubt, to secure his possession of Nassau, win the war for England. And with him will depart a number of soldiers, diminishing the number of bodies between us and Eleanor Guthrie. That many fewer obstacles between us and justice for Charles's murder. If you still wish Anne to lead the vanguard to do it, tell me now. I'll have it done. Would you like to know what I think? I think Anne is right. She said something to me earlier. She said only a fool would give his life to earn the admiration of a corpse. Wanted to strangle her. But part of me could not help but note in that moment she sounded an awful lot like someone else I once knew. Someone you and I both once knew, who shared Anne's mistrust of sentimentality.
Just after he joined my crew, I spent 2 weeks careening on this shit island with no name. I knew right away he was different than the others. He was so like me when I was a younger man. And that he and I somehow were fated to matter to one another. I was consumed with the question of whether our similarities would be a blessing or a curse. So whilst the others were careening, a number of us were inland by a spring. The sun climbs up over the top of the trees in just a way that it shines off the pool, lighting up all around us. In that moment, a bird lands on the water, massive, snow-white beast, big as a boar. To this day, I've never seen anything like it. Between the sun and the size of it, it just felt meaningful. The answer to a question I did not yet know how to ask. I told him that there were men in the East who would have seen in that bird the darkest of all omens, bringer of death. But then, there are other men near a Clifton, my mother's home, who would have called it a sign of great fortune. An indication from the heavens that someone up there favored our endeavor together. I asked him what he thought it meant. Dinner.
There are moments in the dead of night when I can't sleep, and I wonder if I will ever be able to truly rest again until I know that Eleanor Guthrie has paid for what she took from me. And then there are other moments when I wonder if it would actually please him to see her dead, to know the scales have been even, or if despite all they'd been through, despite the anger and the blood and the betrayal, and all he'd done to her, and she to him, despite what I or you or what anybody else might think of it, if wherever he was, he still didn't just a little bit love her. I wonder if if he were here now, watching us battle with the choice to kill her in his name, or defeat the governor, and perhaps therein win the war we altogether started, if he might too call us fools. And then I wonder if maybe we don't have to work that hard to imagine what he'd say. Maybe we've already heard it. And the only choice is whether we choose to listen.
He's underway, Captain. Using the fort guns for cover. Do we pursue?
Slip the cables. Set a course to overtake her.
Slip the cable! Set course to pursue!